afternoon. Welcome to The Point. I'm your host, Luke Rose.
And I'm Christian Hohenberger. We have a lot of fantastic skits and a live update of this presidential election.
That's right. I get to see firsthand how presidential debates actually happen. Let's get right into our first clip with Mr. Beast.
Today, we're in a random high school playing ultimate tag. The winner gets to keep the school, but the loser's getting eliminated. As you can see, this is a big school with literally thousands of hiding places. These are our eight contestants. You can see they're really excited. You guys have 1 minute, go right now. I'm not waiting anymore.
All right, well, I don't know what I'm doing.
Hey, what up, Mr. Bully? Oh, funny guy, I'm running.
Whoa, get out of here.
Oh, I'm literally freaking out. I'm freaking out.
Hey, somebody get Yogi the Bear over here.
No. We're running.
Go. Already running low on time. I don't know what to do.
I can't fit back there.
That's the timer. We gotta go right now.
I'm scared. There's a hole in the ceiling. Yeah. That's basically it.
Famous Carson himself.
What's up?
Subscribe to his YouTube channel.
You guys seen anybody in here running around a little frantically? They ran too fast this time.
Check him out. You want to have a race?
So what? Oh, you kid, what's that noise? We're supposed to be quiet.
Dude, there's nowhere to go.
No, okay. So
there's nowhere to go.
We stay.
No.
You're not supposed to use the walkie-talkie, dude.
Mr. Beast is not made for running.
What? What?
Oh, go.
Oh, crap.
I kind of have the urge to bark into the radio. I think I'm gonna do it. Should I do it?
Can I have a spot? Right here. Bad news, I have no idea how I'm gonna get down.
So right now we're just chilling in the athletic office because Luke called on the walkie talkie and I feel like she's gonna come for us now.
Well, I lost. Where should
hey,
I go now?
Mr. Beast doesn't have long hair.
Nope.
You just stink.
Does Mr. Beast suddenly grow a ponytail? Got a little tired of all the stuff in his face.
Let's give Roger a break. He's tired.
Coming to find you guys.
Mr. Beast is a loser.
Too bad Mr. Beast is a loser.
Got
the cage. This floor is like ice.
Oh, I'm gonna slide down the stairs.
So, I'm leaving.
Oh yeah.
The door's locked.
You screwed us, bro.
Four people down, guys.
She got Luke. That's all I really care about when I'm leaving.
I'd be running.
Are they back there?
Oh my god. Oh,
hello.
Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Jetpack Joyride gameplay. We're gonna be playing some Jetpack Joyride.
I think there's something on the printer for you guys.
Feastables. Feastables.com. MrBeast.com. Get the merch.
We're closing in on a subject.
It's bullying!
She's gonna run towards me because I'm slow.
Oh!
I took off my shoes and everything.
I got out before you did.
I know, I'm not shocked in that.
I don't know. I think I might just stay in here.
We're in pursuit. Attention, we got Justine and Mira.
Moral of the story? Make sure you train to be Mr. Beast.
I'm so scared.
We did not get Christian. We still have two.
I mean,
I hate this school.
You get cut?
Yes.
Doesn't that make Christian the winner?
Christian wins.
No!
All I'm saying is, like, I'm just the best. I win. I win these.
I'm going to punch you.
The title of the school is mine. Like, honestly, I don't know how I don't know how people lost.
We got the winner here after we finally found him after 20 minutes of looking because he doesn't know how to turn on his radio.
Whoa.
Here is the key to the school, and also you might as well just have the key to my car as well.
Sweet.
Because I don't need it.
Thank you.
Now we got our losing contestants here. I promised elimination. I'm gonna release my little monsters that I've raised since they were tiny little babies and I love them with all my heart. We're gonna let them out in three.
Stop right there!
Hey, I'm recording a video!
Get down, get down! Get down, get down!
I'm Mr.
Peter,
you can't be
doing
this.
I told Squid Guy, I told Chisa, don't.
I cannot believe how you came through with the win.
Neither can I.
Now, I did get blocked by the door. I would just like to say that is the office's fault, not mine. They locked me in there so she could catch me. But anyway, let's get on to our next clip with Cooking with Luke Rose and Jacob Miller-Rubidoux.
Good afternoon. You may be wondering what this is. Well, it's his birthday, and we're gonna give him a nice little treat. So we had to cook him something, but we don't know how to cook. So we're gonna film a tutorial to go and watch back and learn how to cook. All right, men and gentlemen,
ladies.
We're in the kitchen. Our ingredients, let's look.
All the way up. It is now.
Okay, so we're gonna take our eggs, obviously, and we're gonna.
Yo, the egg almost fell off.
Hey, this is our egg rack. That's so clean. We need to show that too. Boom. Pop it in. Whatever. Do what we like because it's our eggs. And we're gonna bop. Then we're gonna.
Shroop.
Hold. It's like Bob Ross always says, make love to the canvas. There we go, our three eggs. Now all we have to do is throw these away. And now the site says beat the my experience from the past says beat the eggs. So all you want to do is just boom, pop them, and then you spin it. Just keep spinning until...
Until it looks like this. Now you want to put your fork to the side. Next ingredient we didn't film, Himalayan pink salt, the only way you can have your salt, and some black pepper. And we're going to add just a few for seasoning. Not a lot of black pepper. It's only three eggs, you know. Not a lot of salt, because this here isn't for human consumption. You'll figure out what we mean by that in a minute. Then we take our fork, mix that in. This puppy's ready to fry.
Okay, so now you can put up your ingredients such as the eggs, the salt, the pepper. You may want to add the salt and pepper after, but since you already put it in the bowl, it's okay to go. And so now we're just gonna put it on the stove, get it nice and warm, nice and cooked, flip it, cook that side, add some cheese, and then we're good. But first, we need some butter.
Oh yeah.
Please cut this out because this will be super awkward. Don't do me dirty.
No.
So now we put this on, start cooking.
Stove's not even on.
So now we put this on and start cooking. You want to turn it on. The reason I did that was because
in my experience, if you put it on after, it'll melt too quickly and have uneven sides. So basically me putting it on was like a smart thing to do. Not everyone knows this because they're not experienced, but let's just get this done. Put the butter back and then we're going to slap the eggs on.
So we have to get the final ingredient real quick. Where did I put it? Oh, sweet. Yes.
So we're about to pour our three eggs into the pan. Come get a little close up of this. Oh yeah. Okay, bud, who do you think you are? Get out of here.
It's heavy, I think. I don't know why it's so heavy.
So this is gonna be the thinnest omelet I think I've ever seen in my entire life. But you definitely, oh, we forgot to add the cheese. Get the cheese, hurry.
We add it right now?
Yes, you add it before you close it up.
Hey, hold up. This is gonna be the greatest freaking thing ever. Wait, wait, watch out.
Oh, get that cheese in there for the dramatic effect. Now that the cheese is on here, I think we're ready to flip. We definitely want to get all underneath this piece.
Hello? The Jeopardy music over this.
This is gonna rip. Help me get this thing to flip.
Hey, Tiffany, how? What?
Once it's closed, it can't go back up.
Cap.
No, I think we got it. Pretty good. You put the cheese on before you close it.
You cook it before you close it, bro.
No, you put the cheese in the middle. How are you else supposed to get the cheese inside if you're not gonna...
How are you gonna cook it if it's closed?
What do you mean?
You missed a step.
No. Look, it's starting to cool down.
I'm not gonna lie, this looks so good.
Yeah, see, what did I tell you?
We should put a banana in it. Not this, bro.
Are you guys ready to eat?
Look, bro, why not this? Cilantro.
Oh, yeah, that's what I meant. Same thing. Are you guys almost ready to eat?
Okay, so currently it is ready to be plated. As we can see, the cheese is kind of spilling over the edge because it's very full, but that's how we like it. So yes, let's just plate this real quick and then we can take a closer look, cut it open and see what we got going on inside. So now I did forget, we do have to add some syrup just to add some flavor. It's also good for the bones. It can make you grow, get bigger and stronger. So let's do that. So now we just added it, and let's cut this bad boy open and take a glance at what
we created. Wait. We gotta add the B-roll.
Oh yeah. Give it a whirl. I'm gonna be honest, this is one of the best omelets I've ever had in my life.
It's cap.
Nah, try it.
There's too much cheese in the middle, but so now, other than that.
Overall, great thing.
I'm not feeding this to my chickens because I will... I want it. I'm eating it. Anyway. Brought to you by PlayStation.
This is the point.
This is the point. There is no point to the point. This is a point. Yeah, this is the point. This is a point and this is the point.
That looked like an excellent dish.
Oh, it was. Anyway, we need to go to a break, but we will be right back after this.
Can you show us your best dance moves?
Yes.
How many ghosts chase Pac-Man at the start of each game?
Six.
It's four. You're close, though.
Emmy, are you able to show us your best dance moves?
I don't know.
Oh.
What country drinks the most coffee per capita?
Italy.
Finland.
Finland?
Finland.
High five for her. High five for her.
Are you guys able to show us your best dance moves?
Yeah.
Which country has won the most World Cups? Brazil.
High five for effort though.
I'm forgetting that. Are you able to show us your best dance moves?
Yeah. Alright, bump.
Oh! Slay!
What disease commonly spread on pirate ships?
Oh. I wasn't alive back then.
It was actually scurvy.
Okay.
A high five for A for effort, but I don't want to get my hands all dirty.
I'll give you a high five.
Woo! We're here with this Gavin, and she's going to show us her favorite dance move once we get the music pulled up. Are you excited?
So excited!
Oh, yay, okay.
What artist has the most streams on Spotify?
Taylor Swift.
It's Drake.
What? Are you able to show us your favorite dance move?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh yeah!
Where is the Great Barrier Reef located?
Alaska.
Costa Rica.
It's Australia. Where is the Oval Office in the White House?
Washington, D.C. The second floor.
In the West Wing.
What?
How many bones are in a human body?
206.
211.
206, you're right.
Oh!
Which state produces the most cheese?
Oh, Green Bay, I think. Well, that's not a state.
Wisconsin. Wisconsin.
Wisconsin. A for effort.
Mr. Riggins, are you able to show us your favorite dance move?
I can choose a dance move. I don't know what my favorite, but I can show a
okay.
How many humps does a Daryl Mary camel have?
Three?
One. What is the fifth digit of pi?
Five.
No, it's not. Who is the first Disney princess?
Snow White.
Yeah!
Are you able to show us your best dance move?
My best dance move?
Yeah.
I'm not a very good dancer though.
It's okay, you got it.
Like,
yeah. You got it. Your thoughts on drugs?
Drugs are bad, okay. Don't do drugs.
Why was John Legend jealous of Ryan Gosling in La La Land?
Why?
Because he was jealous how quickly Ryan learned to play jazz piano.
Oh, dude.
Which actor is the most watched man on television?
The Rock.
Is that your final answer?
Yep.
David Hasselhoff.
What?
Yes.
What are you getting that? Wait, a 1980s?
What is the highest grossing movie of all time?
Avatar, the original Avatar.
You're right. A for effort. Are you able to show us your favorite dance move?
Oh yeah, I can.
Are you able to show us your favorite dance move?
Yes.
Are you able to show us your favorite dance move?
Always am.
Okay, you got this. You got this, Dale.
Yeah! Woo! Why are you here and why are you bothering people?
I'm not. We just.
Bothering Riley. Okay. You're bothering me. You're bothering everybody right now. What are you doing? Are all of you bothered right now?
Yes.
Thank you. You need to leave.
They don't care. Their opinions don't matter.
Thank you.
It looks like it's time for the Western Boone presidential election.
Yes, I believe that these candidates are very unqualified, and I'm impressed they made it this far.
I completely agree, especially since I'm one of them.
We're getting ready for the 2024 presidential debate here at the Weibo Auditorium between Senator Mitchell Fries of Indiana and Governor George Meatloaf of Indiana. So, candidates, what's your position on the economy?
I like it.
It's okay.
How dare you say it's okay? This is America. America is the best.
We don't even have free healthcare.
Guys, too much politics and arguing. Let's move on. This is a presidential debate, not a debate. So, what's your guys' favorite pizza?
I like plain cheese.
I like mushroom.
Oh, so you hate America?
Oh, so you're a filthy casual?
Yeah, but at least I don't spread communist rhetoric like you.
Gentlemen, calm down. Let's go to the next subject. What do you think about electrical energy?
Well, why don't you ask my opponent what he thinks?
I was going to, Mr. Meatloaf. But first, what do you think?
Next question.
Okay, Fries?
I know the human being and fish can coexist peacefully.
Okay, so we are ready to make our projection for the next president of the United States, but one more question. What do you think about abortion? This is a shocker, folks. None of these candidates has won in a landslide, capturing 99% of the vote.
We just lost to thin air. Are we really that bad? Do we have to do some introspection?
Nah.
And last but certainly not least, we have Hungry Hungry Hippos, but with a twist.
Welcome to my point segment, which I like to call Hungry, Hungry Hippos?
Welcome to the first annual Hungry Hungry Hippo Tournament. We have freshmen, sophomore, juniors, and seniors all battling it out for the winner.
Now, some of you may be asking, why is this such a big deal? Why are we in the gym if we're recording a board game? It's not a board game today. Today, we are playing Hungry Hungry Hippos in real life.
Yes, they will be using tennis balls and sweeping them up with their hands while rolling on scooters, I guess you could call them.
So we've seen a lot of this on YouTube, on TikTok, on whatever, but we're here to do our own rendition. And so today, we're about to open up the competition and get to know our teams.
Let's go to the beach, eat, let's go get a wave. They say what they gonna say. Have a drink, clink, down.
Here with the Rizzlers, and we're going to be asking a few questions. The first one is, do you have any strategies coming into this match?
You know, Luke, we do not have any strategy whatsoever. We're quite literally some underdogs ready
that
to
is
take on this.
Fantastic.
Okay.
We are here with the Dab Squad and some more questions. So we interviewed the Rizzlers before this, and they didn't have any experience really or anything. So how do you think you differ from their team?
We're way better, and I have a super senior on my team.
Baba Booey.
She has a sophomore.
Has a super senior played before?
Yeah.
So is she good?
Yeah.
Experience and everything. Okay.
We're here with the Thug Shakers, mm-hmm. obviously our sophomore team. So what's your plan going into this game?
Right, so there's an assortment of balls over there, and so me and Carter, we've been training alone at home, right? Just really getting comfortable with catching the balls, right? Just right in our hands, just right there cupping them. Our plan is to just scoot out there, run out there. He's going to use that practice to good use.
And boom, we're going to win.
All right, well, good luck, good luck. All right, we're here with a whole lot of turbulence, the youngest team out here on the block. What's your guys' plan going into this game?
Get out there, grab all the balls, and just stay for the victory.
All right, that's a good plan. Short and sweet. All right, good luck, good luck.
All right, thank you, sir.
You ready, Carter?
Yeah.
Grab my leg, Sherman.
And we're off. They're rolling in, grabbing all of them. Hopefully that camera moved, and it did. It looks like it's going to be okay. Sophomore team doing a swing.
Hey, sophomore team.
Beautiful
coming in with a
swing.
We
that
got one person
amazing.
Cleaning up the balls. Carter over here getting a good amount of balls. The senior team is lackluster right now. The freshman team lackluster right now. I feel like most of the balls, actually, no, look over there. They are missing a few balls.
And now there are a lot on that senior side, though, getting cleaned up by Cam, so.
A lot of the balls went to the right.
It looks like they're going to steal them.
Oh,
sophomore team coming in with the steal. This is amazing. Ball's coming our way. There's some outside of the area. Outside everywhere.
Oh my
this
goodness.
Is intense.
Oh, you need to lose some weight. Sophomore team tiring out.
And
time's
time
up. The game is
up.
Over. We will be counting up the balls.
I'm going to be honest. It looks pretty even right now.
Seniors, 27. Sophomores, 25. Yo,
freshman team with 40 tennis balls.
40 tennis balls. All the other teams were in the 20s.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. We got this.
Just the underdog team, like I was saying, bro. I expected them to have the least the whole game.
Yes, you did.
Yet they pulled out with the win.
Youngest team out here.
Youngest team out here.
And they take the win.
Attention, everyone. We had upcoming news. This is our last round coming in. So we only had two rounds. This is our last one. The freshmen and the sophomores are merging. And like you expect, the juniors and seniors will be merging too.
Now, this seems incredibly uneven, but the freshmen did win last game. So let's see if they can pull through.
This may seem uneven, but I'm going to keep it real with you. Boys versus girls. You never know what's going to happen. Obviously, freshman won. They got a lot of agile kids on their team. Sophomores were putting in work pretty fast as well, but they tired out at the end. What are your thoughts on the seniors and juniors?
Well, they started off very well, but did not do as well as I thought they would. I thought that they were going to take first place on that. It looked like more than they had. Freshmen didn't look like they had very many, but apparently they had so much. And the freshmen do have longer arms since they are men.
What did he say?
You guys make fun of him?
Right, seniors versus freshmen. SJSF. Competition is about to start. What are your thoughts right now in this moment as we're about to start?
It's very intense. My nerves are
very intense.
All over the place. Stomach turning in knots. I'm so excited.
Everyone's quiet. We got a shot live.
Two cameras in the middle. They going hard.
Seniors,
almost headbutt.
Grabbing
but
so
they...
many balls.
Wow.
Freshmen are down so much. Oh, no, look. They're all up. Everyone is up. We got team
They're
two going in.
They're getting close to hitting
more.
Each other right now.
That is crazy.
Went
I'm surprised
right
no fingers have
camera.
Been crushed. I'm surprised no fingers have been crushed.
That is going to be a really good shot, them going right over the camera. Hopefully it is okay. Fox looks like he's using it, so it does look okay.
Camera caught under the thing.
We need that camera out of there so we can just save it and it doesn't break.
Hey, sophomores and freshmen have a pretty good sweep. 10 seconds left on the clock.
Seniors can get these left. It looks like they'll be in the lead. Go back around, sweep.
And that's game. We'll be counting up the winnings. Both teams are counting up the winnings.
You guys feel like you got it? You guys feel like you, how do you feel you do? You got it?
Yeah. If you guys don't,
100%, 100%.
16, 17.
Teen seniors?
19, 20, 21.
Oh. Oh.
Sorry. Oh. I'm really excited. I get it. I'm really excited. Yeah. I can't breathe my knees.
You guys think you got it?
50.
Where are we at?
57.
55.
56.
They already won.
57.
Yes!
Yeah! All I do is win, no matter what.
I'm sorry, Lizzie.
Anyways, thanks for coming out, everyone. Thank you, Luke, for being my co-host commentator.
You're
I'm
welcome.
Also co-host. There's no,
it was very
no
fun.
Lead commentator here. Both co-hosts here. And our special guest here, don't know when he arrived, but he's here. He's been
and
here for the last game.
Congratulations to the seniors and juniors for taking the win. An astonishing game and first of the year.
Number one victory royale, yeah, Fortnite, we bout to get down.
Get down.
10 kills on the board right now, just wiped out Tomato Town. My friend just gone down, I revived him, now we're heading southbound. Now we're in the Pleasant Park streets, look at the map, go to the mark.
That's all for this episode. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and share.
Have a great day.